We're doing a randomized clinical trial of remdesivir, which is an experimental treatment for COVID-19. It's an experimental antiviral that has been used in the past for other viral infections. It has no known specific action against coronavirus or COVID-19, but it's been tried in China, and now we're doing the clinical trial here in the U.S. to see if it may help. The goal of the remdesivir trial is really to understand whether something that's currently available can be used to treat people with COVID-19. And then the other study is really much more exploratory. Can we figure out what this good immune response is and dissect out what we can do with the samples that we collect from people who've recovered and then develop targeted therapies that could help in the future? And I think what we need to do is to look at these early responses and then to look at the responses over time so that we can say that people who mount, for example, a high neutralizing antibody response to this infection, then this is what we want to mimic for a vaccine. We don't know a lot about this new coronavirus. We don't think it behaves like the flu. We think it takes a longer for people to mount a protective immune response to it, but that study hasn't been done yet. So we're looking at comparing those who do well and then those who don't do well and seeing if there are differences in their antibody response and also looking at their just a variety of other immune responses to see if we can find a profile so that ultimately, when you are looking to develop a vaccine, then you can compare it against this and say, this is what looks like a success, and this is what doesn't look like a success. And then we can have a way of sort of being able to look at those vaccine candidates and decide earlier whether to move them forward. To get to a vaccine or a monoclonal is going to take months to years. I mean, I think that even now, we're starting to understand what exactly is a good antibody. But then to be able to pull that out and then to make large quantities of monoclonal antibodies and then to run that through a clinical trial is several months away. We are seeing this random distribution of who's getting sick. We see 20-year-olds, 30-year-olds, 40 to 50-year-olds, and these people are not doing well. And the older people are certainly at higher risk, and if you have a chronic condition, you're certainly at higher risk, but there's a very random component to this virus that is difficult. I mean, I think for all of us, as clinicians, as researchers, the fact that 20 to 30 to 40-year-olds are dying of this is unexpected, and it's hard to deal with.